Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel Sparkle English, where I teach you how to improve your level of English. If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one. In today's video, I'm going to teach you about run-on sentences, how to identify run-on sentences, and how to fix them. This is very important when you are looking to improve your English writing skills. So what is a run-on sentence? Run-on sentences happen when two or more complete sentences are combined without using proper punctuation or conjunctions. For example, I'm exhausted, I can't study anymore. Let's go to the cinema, I want to see the new Marvel movie. My boyfriend took me out for dinner, we ate sushi. All three of these sentences are run-on sentences. They are incorrect. We need to use proper punctuation or conjunctions to fix these sentences. There are two types of run-on sentences: fused sentences and comma splices. A fused sentence happens when independent clauses are combined without any punctuation or conjunctions to separate them. For example, my teacher marked my paper, she said it was great. Here we have two independent clauses. My teacher marked my paper is one independent clause, and she said it was great is a second independent clause. These are two sentences that function separately and function on their own, so we can't just combine them without adding proper punctuation or a conjunction. The other type of run-on sentence is a comma splice, and a comma splice happens when two or more independent clauses are incorrectly joined by a comma. For example, Mom went shopping, she needed to get coffee and milk. Many people will add a comma here instead of a period, and this is a mistake. Now I'm going to show you four different ways we can fix run-on sentences. But first, how can you identify a run-on sentence? The best way to identify a run-on sentence is to check if there is more than one independent clause in the same sentence without punctuation or a conjunction. So, for example, Roger needs us in the conference room. The meeting is in an hour. This sentence is a fused sentence, and in the second example with the comma, this would be a comma splice, and both of these are incorrect. So now let's look at four different ways we can fix a run-on sentence. Number one is make separate sentences. So Roger needs us in the conference room, period, and then capitalize the next word for the second sentence. The meeting is in an hour. So now we have separated these into two independent clauses, and this is correct. The second way you can fix run-on sentences is to add a coordinating conjunction like and, or, but, so, for, nor, or yet. Of course, make sure the coordinating conjunction makes sense in the sentence. You could say, Roger needs us in the conference room and the meeting is in an hour. Now remember to place a comma before the conjunction when joining two independent clauses with a coordinating conjunction. I have more videos on how to properly use commas, but it's very important to remember when joining two independent clauses with a coordinating conjunction that you have to put a comma before the coordinating conjunction. The third way to fix a run-on sentence is to add a semicolon if the sentences are closely related. So Roger needs us in the conference room, semicolon. The meeting is in an hour. The reason Roger needs everyone in the conference room is because they're having a meeting. So these sentences are closely related. So we can use a semicolon. And remember, when you use a semicolon, you do not capitalize the next word. You just keep that in lowercase. unless, of course, it's a word that always begins with a capital letter. And the fourth way to fix a run-on sentence is to add a subordinating conjunction. So Roger needs us in the conference room because the meeting is in an hour. Now, subordinating conjunctions are a bit more powerful than coordinating conjunctions, and we do not need to use a comma in this case. So let's look at our other examples from earlier and see how we can fix them. The first example, I'm exhausted. I can't study anymore. How could we fix this? For example, we could add a semicolon. The next example, let's go to the cinema. I want to see the new Marvel movie. For this example, let's just separate it into two different sentences. Add a period. The third example, my boyfriend took me out for dinner. We ate sushi. For this one, let's add a coordinating conjunction. And remember to add the comma before the coordinating conjunction and. So now it's time for you to practice. We're going to do a practice test out of 8. Some of them are correct. Some of them are not run-on sentences, but the majority of them are run-on sentences, and you have to correct them. Again, you can use any of the 4 methods that we just learned to fix run-on sentences. First, I'm going to read all 8. Number 1, it was raining, they didn't go to the beach. Number 2, Tracy is starting a new job tomorrow, she's the project manager. Number 3, when I grow up, I want to be an actress. Number 4, I'm excited about going home for Christmas. We're going to go skiing. Number 5, Stan goes to the gym every morning. Sticking to a routine is important to him. Number 6, my freedom is important to me. It makes my life more enjoyable. Number 7, I need to buy a new laptop, mouse, and printer next week at the computer shop. And finally, number 8. Joe needs to study if he wants to pass the exam. I'm not sure he will. So let's correct these together. Number 1 is incorrect. This is a run-on sentence. It was raining, they didn't go to the beach. Here we could correct this again in many different ways. The way I'm going to choose to correct this is to add a comma after raining and put the coordinating conjunction so. It was raining, so they didn't go to the beach. Number 2 is incorrect. This is a comma splice. Again, I have a video on comma splices, which is a type of run-on sentence and is a very common mistake. We have 2 independent clauses here. Tracy is starting a new job tomorrow, and she's the project manager. These are 2 independent sentences. We need to separate these sentences correctly, and a comma is not strong enough to combine these sentences. So let's add a semicolon. A semicolon is perfect here. Both of the sentences are closely related. And again, we do not capitalize she's when we use a semicolon. Number 3 is correct. In number 3, you might think this is a comma splice because we have a comma like we did here in number 2. But this is not a comma splice because I want to be an actress is an independent clause. This is a complete sentence. When I grow up is not an independent clause. If you walked up to someone and you said, when I grow up, it doesn't make any sense. It's a dependent clause. And after a sentence starts with a dependent clause, we use a comma before the independent clause. So this is correct as it is. Number 4 is incorrect. I'm excited about going home for Christmas. We're going to go skiing. Let's separate this into 2 different sentences. We're going to put a period after Christmas and then capitalize we're. Number 5 is a little more difficult. This is also incorrect. Stan goes to the gym every morning. Sticking to a routine is important to him. We have 2 independent clauses. Stan goes to the gym every morning. Sticking to a routine is important to him. So here, I'm going to add a semicolon. Number 6, my freedom is important to me. It makes life more enjoyable. This is also incorrect. This is a comma splice. We have two independent clauses. So we need to separate these either into two different sentences, or we could also add a semicolon. I'm going to separate this into two separate sentences and capitalize it. Number 7 is correct. This is not a run-on sentence. I need to buy a new laptop, mouse, and printer next week at the computer shop. This sentence is perfect as it is. And the last one, Joe needs to study if he wants to pass the exam. I'm not sure who he will. This is also a run-on sentence. It is incorrect. In this one, we have Joe needs to study if he wants to pass the exam. I'm going to put a comma after exam and write but I'm not sure he will. Okay, so let me know how many you got correct out of 8. And if you want more practice on run-on sentences, make sure to click on the link in the description below to check out my video on comma splices. Let me know in the comments section how many you got correct out of 8, and if there are any other topics about English writing or grammar that you would like me to cover in future videos. Thank you guys once again for watching, and I will see you in my next lesson.